offering is the truth. Nothing but.
Well, this might be a good conversation starter. Do you believe the Earth is a sphere? The answers you get might surprise you.
The curving horizon, the sloping sea level, the spin of the Earth. Unless you can see these phenomena with your own eyes, they may not be true. Unlike what we've been told in school, the Earth looks like a snow globe, round but not sphere. The North Pole is at the center of most flat Earth maps, with the ice of Antarctica holding everything in.
The round or spherical Earth theory is propagated by some conspiracy.
And the number of people who think so is growing. Thousands, if not millions of people believe the world is flat.
And it's the subject of tonight's special report. WCIA3's Aaron Eads is here with us now. And Aaron, as far as conspiracy theories go, flat Earth theory is actually getting pretty popular.
Yeah. The number of people who believe the Earth is flat is actually growing. Scientists might have an idea of why that is, and it's worth talking about. And what better place to do so than one of the flattest places in the country, right here in central Illinois? It doesn't get much flatter than this. Geological survey data shows Douglas County is the flattest county in Illinois, which is the second flattest state in the whole country. On a clear day, it seems like you can see forever, but you can't. Through the eyes of a person of an average height, the horizon is about 3 miles away. But that's it. You can go up higher to see a greater distance, but you'll never be able to see the whole world no matter how high you get. But there are ideas that this is a sham. NASA, a fraudulent organization bent on siphoning your tax dollars. The moon landing didn't happen.
Those iconic blue marble images seen from space, fakes.
You start seeing words like composite or animation or, you know, something that tells you this is not an actual photograph of the Earth.
The biggest concern with the flat Earth movement is how fast it's gaining steam. Scientists are worried that flat Earth could become a political issue like climate change, vaccination, or evolution. Guys.
All right. Fascinating stuff. All right, Aaron, thank you.
Very interesting.
Well, new this morning, all our lives, we've been taught that there's little doubt that the Earth is round, of course. We've seen the images from space, but not everyone's really convinced.
There's a whole group of people who are not convinced. Some common themes are the Earth is not a sphere, as you said. It's not moving. We are not spinning on an axis or revolving around anything. And biblical literalists, believing the Earth and everything we see when we look up in the sky exists in sort of a dome. That's the belief of organizer Robbie Davidson. He does believe that mainstream science deliberately hides a creator or God. And he says it's become taboo to question science.
They become authority figures that are so high, you can't even question them. And I think it's dangerous for anybody to be at a point where they can't be questioned or critiqued or looked into.
The billboard for the convention just went up along E-470.
People can go there, be uninhibited about their beliefs, what they think. They can discuss it openly and freely.
As a pilot and engineer, Bob used to think it was crazy. So what about astronauts?
The space shots are actually shot in a swimming pool. And they are shot in a place that's called the NASA Neutral Buoyancy Lab, okay? And in this Neutral Buoyancy Lab, they have a full-size mock-up of the ISS.
Lynn, NASA calls it their Neutral Buoyancy Lab. It's just behind Ellington Field here and is becoming an important source of new revenue. NASA's Neutral Buoyancy Lab simulates space underwater. In a pool 4 stories deep and so wide, we saw astronauts floating on one full-size International Space Station replica.
Bob knows this is controversial. He welcomes debates and says,
investigate it yourself. Do your own research. That's what matters.
If you are curious about the international conference, make sure to visit us online. We have more information there at cbsdenver.com. Live in Denver, Jamie Leary covering Colorado First.
But I would say that people should have a better understanding of why it is they believe what they believe. The answer really is because all the smart people say so. And that should never be your baseline of why you think something is or is not true. I did not think I'd get applause for that, by the way. That was nice.
So Buck just said the Earth is flat. That is freaking me out. All right.
It's not a way to make friends and you know, impress your family, because if they're not willing to look, they're going to think you're crazy.
And many attending the conference here say the theory has really gained popularity over the past few years, enough popularity where they can hold conferences like this.
One factor of the growing popularity may be the coverage in the media. It became a hot topic recently when Duke's very own Kyrie Irving came out and claimed he believes the Earth is flat.
Kyrie is my little brother. He's my all-star point guard, superstar point guard, and if he decides he wants to say the Earth is flat, then so be it. So he's an interesting guy, man. And, you know, he believes it. So, Kyrie, the Earth is flat, right?
Yeah.
So whatever.
That's news.
There we go.
Earth is flat. There's no concrete information except for the information that they're giving us. They're particularly putting you in the direction of what to believe and what not to believe.
Is this like a long troll game? Are we being trolled?
I don't think we're being trolled, because if you want to talk about anything that's scientific, two things must be met. Is it reliable and is it valid? I just got off of a flight from Connecticut seeing my daughter, and this is a reliable.
She's doing good.
And then let me guess, the plane went straight. So
let me just say this, Mama. So I heard Kyrie talking about it, and I said, let me do my own scientific experience. Let me take a look out this window.
Nope.
At 36,000 feet, I saw the skyline. And you know what I didn't see? A round skyline.
It was
flat from the left, and I went on the other side of the plane. It was flat on the right. Kyrie done broke it down.
You may have seen it on your way to work or school or just driving around. A new billboard has some people thinking about the Earth.
And asking the question, could the Earth be flat? Greg Argos is here with more on the movement.
Just yesterday, in fact, this billboard, a digital billboard, unveiled yesterday, and it's calling into question a theory most of us have accepted, that the Earth, of course, is round. But those behind this billboard say, well, we've all been tricked.
NASA's pictures and spacewalks showing a curved Earth are all made up. Drivers heading eastbound on the Schuylkill already battle some serious traffic. But now there's another distraction slowing them down, and it's just 100 feet above their heads. Sandwiched between two insurance ads is this bold three-word billboard, Research Flat Earth. And for at least the next week, this ad will be blocking drivers' attention.
Next, we have the, oh, yes, it is, it's a flat Earth after all.
Oh, wow.
Always a fan favorite. This float celebrates flat Earth theory that is spreading, ironically, around the world. What do you think the Earth is flat?
It's a flat world after all.
Top six answers on the board. We asked 100 men, what would you do if your beautiful date told you the Earth was flat?
Laugh at her. Tell her she lying.
Tell her she lying. Pass the point.
We're playing.
Let's play. All right, Sarah, you talked to 100 men. What would you do if your beautiful date told you the Earth was flat?
I hope he'd agree with me.
Agree
good
with
answer.
Her. I would. I just met you. We're on a date. You fine? You tell me the Earth flat? That's cool. I agree.
I mean, it's your turn.
I think I'm gonna solve it.
All right, go ahead.
Okay, the Earth looks pretty flat to me.
Yeah, that's it. There you go. Why risk it?
All I'm offering is the truth. Nothing more.